The Emperor Xianfeng was called Yi Zhu. He was the first son of the Emperor Dao Guang. When Yi Zhu was 10 years old, his biological mother, the Empress Xiao Quancheng, suddenly passed away. Dao Guang led the noble consort Qing to take care of Yi Zhu and promoted the noble consort Qing to the imperial noble consort Qing. The imperial noble consort Qing had a son called Yi Xin. He was 2 years younger than Yi Zhu. Two brothers spent a happy childhood in Zhongcui Gong. But with they grow up, those close brothers had to face the problem that all royal brothers must face, the competition for the throne. Different with Ming Dynasty, that Dizi, son of the empress, had absolute priority to inherit the throne. In Qing Dynasty, the capabilities of the prince were also important consideration. So, Yi Xin, depending on his great capabilities, was considered by his father as heir. Dao Guang took very long time to make decision. Finally, he chose Yi Zhu. In Qing Shi Gao, there were two stories might indicate why Dao Guang made this decision. The first story happened in a spring. Dao Guang bringing Yi Zhu and Yi Xin to hunt. Both Yi Zhu and Yi Xin know this was a test. So, Yi Xin hunted animals as many as he could. Yi Zhu wasn't good at hunting. He hunted nothing, but actually won the test. How? Why? What happened? Yes, Yi Zhu was bad at hunting, but he had a smart teacher, Du Shou Tian. Du Shou Tian know if depending on Yi Zhu's hunting capability, no chance to win. So he told Yi Zhu hunted nothing. When the emperor asked why, Yi Zhu only needed to answer, "It's springtime. All animals were growing and making next generations. I'm not cold enough to kill them." As Du Shou Tian planned, Dao Guang was deeply moved by Yi Zhu's answer. The second story happened when the Emperor Dao Guang was hopeless sick. He got Yi Zhu and Yi Xin beside his bed and asked their plan about ruling the country. Yi Xin confidently presented his plan. "Well," Yi Zhu didn't answer this question. He just cried and consoled his father. Yi Zhu's cheek worked again. Yi Zhu's behavior made Dao Guang believe that Yi Zhu was a kindness, warm-hearted person. In ancient Chinese culture, this behavior was called Ren. Ren was a character that an emperor must have. Eventually, Dao Guang elected Yi Zhu as his heir, but also recognized Yi Xin's capabilities. So, in the will, Dao Guang wrote Yi Zhu inherited the throne, and Yi Xin was promoted to Qin Wang, the prince. In Qing history, it was the only time that the late emperor announced his heir and promoted a Qin Wang at the same time in one will. After the throne competition, the relationship between the two brothers had no chance to come back. In 1850, Yi Zhu became the Emperor Xianfeng. Yi Xin became the Prince Gong. At beginning, their relationship was not so bad, until one thing happened in 1855. In 1855, the Emperor Xianfeng had to promote his foster mother, who was Yixin's biological mother, the imperial noble consort daughter Kangzi, to the empress daughter. Xianfeng's biological mother, the empress Xiao Chengquan, passed away in 1840. In the same year, the noble consort Jing was promoted to the imperial noble consort. Because the noble consort Jing was really healthy, everyone thought eventually she would become the empress. Unfortunately, the imperial noble consort Jing waited and waited until 1850. The emperor Daoguang passed away. She was still the imperial noble consort. She was the actual host of the inner court for 10 years, but could not get the title of the host. When Yizhu, his foster son, became the emperor, she wished Yizhu could promote her to the empress daughter, but the emperor Xianfeng didn't, using the excuse that no examples of promoting the foster mother to the empress daughter. The emperor Xianfeng promoted his foster mother to the imperial noble consort daughter Kangzi, but living conditions were same as the empress daughter. Again, the imperial noble consort daughter Kangzi became the actual empress daughter without the title. In 1855, the imperial noble consort daughter Kangzi was hopelessly sick. The Prince Gong knew getting the title was his mother's biggest wish. So, beside his mother's bed, he begged Xianfeng to satisfy his mother's wish. In this situation, Xianfeng could not clearly refuse. The Prince Gong, without Xianfeng's clearly agreement, using his position in the court, immediately announced, promoted the imperial noble consort daughter Kangzi to the empress daughter. 8 days later, the new empress daughter passed away at 44. This time, she got the title, but didn't get the real empress treatment. After her funeral was finished, Xianfeng deprived Prince Gong's old positions in the court and let him study in Shangshufang. In 1860, Beijing was captured by the British and French forces. Xianfeng escaped to the Chengde Bishu Shanzhuang and required the Empress Gong stayed in Beijing. After negotiation, the Prince Gong signed the Convention of Beijing on behalf of the Qing government. In 1661, Xianfeng passed away in Bishu Shanzhuang. Before that, Xianfeng appointed 8 ministers regents. The Prince Gong was excluded, so he had to wait another opportunity to come back the center of the power. Soon, the opportunity came. After Tong Zhi became the emperor, the empress daughter Cixi wanted to Qi Lian Ting Zheng. 8 ministers regents refused. After getting the promotion from the empress daughter Cian, Cixi got a political alliance with the Prince Gong. In November 1861, 2 empress daughters and Prince Gong launched a coup in history known as Xin You Zheng Bian. The 8 regents were arrested and removed from their positions. Ci An and Ci Xi started to Qi Lian Ting Zheng. The Prince Gong was promoted as Prince Regent. Thank you for watching this video. Tomorrow, let's see the story of two empress daughters in Emperor Xianfeng's inner court.